Welcome, dear students. How are you? I'm sure you people are doing well. I am Sadhya Sarwan and I am back with 4th SST lesson. So what we are going today? We are going to do exercise of chapter 5. So what is the name of chapter 5? The name of chapter 5 is The Land and Agriculture of Pakistan and South Asia. But before starting the exercise, let's first recapitulate this chapter. So what we have discussed in this chapter, we have discussed about the composition of land in Pakistan and India. First of all, can you tell me why is agriculture important for a country? Exactly, it is a source of food supply. And secondly, why Pakistan is called an agriculture-based country? Exactly, because majority of the population lives in the countryside and villages and their occupation is agriculture. So if you want to find out the composition of land in Pakistan and India, so you have to look at the picture at page number 17 and page number 21. You can make the comparison and you can know how much of the land is comprises of forest, scrubland, agricultural land and mountain and desert in both Pakistan and India. Let's discuss about desert, farmland, wasteland and scrubland. You are familiar with the word desert, farmland, wasteland. But there is a word scrubland that is new to you. But I'm sure it's not that much new because you people have read the chapter and I'm sure that it's clear to you. Exactly, scrubland has a poor soil and very little rainfall. But it will grow rough grass and some tough shrubs. Okay? Now, let's discuss about the physical and climatic features of Bangladesh, Nepal and Bhutan, Sri Lanka and Maldives. Okay, let's first discuss about Bangladesh. So, what was the previous name of Bangladesh? Exactly, East Pakistan. And Bangladesh became an independent state on 17 December 1971. Basically, the climate of Bangladesh is hot and humid. The climate of Nepal and Bhutan is actually very landlocked countries. Okay. And let's talk about the Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is actually most affected by the tsunami because it is a pear-shaped island lies off the southeastern coast of the Indian Peninsula. And let's discuss about Maldives. Maldives is located in the Indian Ocean to the southwest of India and Sri Lanka. So, that was all about recapitulation of this chapter. Now, let's start the exercise. First of all, I would request you all to please open your neat notebooks. So, what you are going to do on your neat notebooks, you are going to open your neat notebooks and then you are going to write down the very first question of the exercise at page number 23. So, what is the question number 1? Question 1 is, people who use wood for construction and fuel cut down trees without much thought. How does this affect forest? Let's start the answer to this question. So, the answer to the first question is, due to indiscriminate cutting down of trees for fuel and construction, the forest which were once natural vegetation for Pakistan have shrunk in size and only 5.2% of ground cover. As a result, deforestation and desertification is taken place. The soil is damaged and washed away by rains and floods. Trees, if planted to replace those cut down, take many years to grow and mature. Now giving you few minutes to complete your question. Now, let's start the question number 2. Question 2 is, why is forward needed in some part of the Pakistan? What is the government trying to do to solve the problem? Okay, let's start the answer to the question number 2. There are two parts of this question, so we will write separately. First part, firewood is vital in many rural areas for fuel, for cooking and heating. Because there is no electricity or gas available, people used to cook outdoors and they found it difficult to adapt a new method. Also, firewood is free. It just has to be cut down or collected. Now, part 2, you will start from the new paragraph, okay? The government is trying to solve this problem through electrification, provision of gas pipelines, education, and creating awareness about the importance of forests. Now, let's start question number 3. Question 3 is, what is the importance of agriculture for Pakistan? What are the sources of water for agriculture? Again, two parts of this question. Let's start first part. Pakistan is not rich in mineral resources and most of its land is not suitable for agriculture. However, because of the river system which provide irrigation, agriculture is possible. Point 2, agriculture is important because of the increase in the population and also it reduces import of food crops. Now, part 2. Sources of water for agriculture are flood water, which is stored in dam, barrages, river, tube well, rainwater. But this is not sufficient, and irrigation. Now, I am giving you few minutes to complete your questions, okay? Do remember, don't forget to write down the question and drawing the ending a margin line. Okay, students, now that's enough for today. Do complete your notebook. See you inshallah ta'ala in the next class. Till then, Allah Hafiz and have a great, great day.